Hi there, welcome to Smart Way of Learning Concepts and Enjoy Learning. The goal of this video is to make you learn or let you know the design issues of a flip-flop such as setup time and hold time. Consider a flip-flop. It is push-to-edge triggered. Here we give the input and we get the output here. If we consider a push-to-edge triggered flip-flop, then the clock signal, setup time and hold time are as follows. Setup time. It is the amount of time before the active edge of the clock during which the input signal should remain constant so that input data is successfully stored by the flip-flop and it is denoted by TS. Hold time. It is the amount of time after the active edge of the clock during which input data should remain constant so that input data is successfully stored by the flip-flop and it is denoted by TH. So, setup time is the amount of time before the active edge of the clock during which the input signal must remain stable so that input data is successfully stored by the flip-flop. If the input is not constant during setup time, then the flip-flop stores incorrect data and we name this condition as setup time violation. Hold time. It is the amount of time after the active edge of the clock during which the input data must remain stable. If the input is not constant during hold time, the flip-flop captures incorrect data and it is known as hold time violation. When input 1 is given to this flip-flop, since it is constant during setup and hold time, there is no setup and hold time violation and hence the device successfully stores 1 after second rising clock edge. When input 2 is given, since there is a signal transition from 0 to 1 during the setup time, the flip-flop suffers from setup time violation. Similarly, when input 3 is given, it is not stable during hold time, hence the flip-flop suffers from hold time violation. From this analysis, it is clear that if there is setup time or hold time violation or both, the flip-flop stores incorrect data and its output is unpredictable. So one needs to take care of these design issues while designing sequential circuits. In the next video, we will consider a sequential circuit and check for setup and hold time violations and also some ways to overcome these design issues. Thanks for watching the video. If you like it, then hit on the like button down there. Subscribe and hit the bell button for many more interesting updates. Have a great time.